Hi, and welcome back to Greenmark Builders TV. I'm Mark from Greenmark Builders. Today we're talking about the process of drilling a well. We've got the good guys from Capital Water Supply here putting in the well. Our goal is always to keep the well in the range of about 100 feet. When drilling a well, your goal should always be to stay as shallow as you can. Although, in some dry conditions in the summer, sometimes you'll hear of people's wells drying up. Our goal is to make our wells as shallow as we can so we don't get into extra costs for our homeowners. Sometimes if you don't go deep enough with your well, in dry conditions, say in a really hot summer, you may run into some problems. In this subdivision that we're working in right now, three of our neighbors ended up having to re-drill their wells to go deeper so they could get into another aquifer and more water. Because of this reason, what we did was we decided to go deeper with this well. We try not to go beyond the 200-foot mark to stay out of the minerals, but in this well, we're sitting at about 220 to 250 feet. A common misconception is that well water has an odor to it. Well, I'm here to tell you right now that most of the time, that is not the case.
I'm here with Steve from Capital Water Supply. He's the man in charge of drilling the well for this home. Steve, tell us a little bit about what the process is for drilling a well.
Well, the first thing, the important thing is to make sure the casing is set properly and grouted properly, and make sure it's in with the guidelines of the subdivision. Some subdivisions have extra casing, extra grout. Some subdivisions have engineers required, some don't.
Okay, so how would say somebody interested in building in a certain area find out information about something like that?
Well, you give us a call. We can get on the website, the Ministry of Environment website, and they have a lot of wells registered right back to 1950 now.
Wow, 1950. Wow, that's great.
And any well now that is tagged, of course they're all tagged now. If a well nearby you is tagged, it's very, very good information off.
Okay, excellent. So a common misconception for people is well water smells. What is it that makes well water smell, or does it really smell?
Well, a lot of it is a gas. It makes water smell. Bad iron will make water smell. There's probably other things. Gas itself can make water smell, like methane.
Okay. So when you're drilling a well, what kind of pockets are you looking for when you drill? You were talking to me earlier about hitting a shale. What does that mean, and where do you hit that?
In this area here, we're sitting on top of limestone. Underneath the limestone will be what they call the Rockcliff shale, which is a red and green colored shale.
Okay.
Much softer than the harder limestone up top. And there'll be streaks of sandstone in that, and that's usually where you'll find your water. And in this case here, it'll be down probably between 200 and 250 or 275 feet.
Okay, excellent. Well, thanks so much for taking the time, Steve. I really appreciate your time.
Not a problem.
Okay.